Hey, you guys, it's me, Allie. We'll call this pillow talk, shall we? I'm in my bedroom and I was getting ready for bed and, well, I'm not really tired, so I grabbed a pillow and I'm sitting on the floor and I figured I better do a video because I haven't posted one in quite some time. And I just want you guys to know that the last couple of months I haven't really been okay and something happened, which I'll post later. The pillow is really distracting, isn't it? Okay, so the thing is, I've been reading a lot on Facebook, and I'm lurking. Just because I'm not on it doesn't mean I'm not lurking. But there are people who are really, really excited about gastric bypass who are about to get it. But there are some things I just want to share with whoever's watching this. If you haven't had surgery yet, I just want you to listen. Okay, I just want you to listen for just a minute, okay? Because I made this mistake, and tonight my friend Julie and I were talking about it, and I wish I could scream this from a billboard, and I wish I got this, like really got it, before I had surgery. Your taste buds are going to change. If you love protein shakes today because you're pre-surgery, if you really love certain things that you think is great because it's going to get you through your surgery and that's how you're going to be eating when you're after you've had gastric bypass, it's not true. Everything you're going through right now, pre-surgery, is going to change once you get out of the operating room. I promise you. Julie promises you. The things I used to love, I don't. The things I really liked, I don't. The things I never liked, like salt and pepper or salt and vinegar potato chips, I love. You guys all know that. But I'm just saying, there's a few of my friends that are really gung-ho on getting gastric bypass. And they're trying, they're you know, doing the mannerisms that we live our life. And the one thing that wasn't told is that it's not going to be like this. Everything you're learning, everything you know right now, it's all going out the window for when you get pushed out of the operating room and you're laying in that room by yourself for those few moments of clarity when you realize your new life has begun. Well, I don't know why I'm getting so emotional. This is kind of odd. Wow, I haven't done that before. When you're laying in that room for a few minutes and you're by yourself or your friend's with you or something, and they're not talking, they're just kind of reading because you need to sleep or whatnot, just remember, your life is now a new journey. You're on a new journey. So everything that happened before gastric bypass, it's not going to matter. I mean, don't get me wrong, it is going to matter. Those things that I lived my life for 20 years fat or whatever, and I'm 153 pounds today, 153 pounds weight loss. I haven't really said that out loud. I mean, I've written it before, but I guess when I did my stand up in Vegas and stuff, you know, I said that and I made a joke and I said that I lost the equivalent of an Olsen twin in her Chanel bag. But you know what the reality is? I lost a whole person, and that was my person. I lost half of me, and I don't want to get her back. I don't want that back. Everything I thought I knew before gastric bypass, I didn't. And I wouldn't change a thing. I don't have any regrets. And I say that like that because I know I've been reading so much of people having regrets. Listen, I just want you to listen. Your whole world is in front of you. Your whole life is in front of you now. So enjoy it and take every moment in that you can, because you're going to be another beautiful person. You already are. Regardless of if you're sitting here watching this and you weigh 400 pounds and you weigh 500 pounds or you weigh 338 pounds like I did. I don't care. Regardless of what your weight is and you haven't had surgery yet and you're getting ready and you have a date and you're scared, be scared. But you know what you do with that fear? Be excited. Be excited because you're one of us now. You're in a WLS community. And there's a million of us that'll help you. So if you're watching this and you're scared, it's okay. It's okay to be scared. Make sure you reach out to at least one person you know isn't going to leave you after surgery because you're all thin and pretty and stuff, or whatever reason they leave you. Because things will change. Relationships will change with people. You're going to change. Me, personally, I can only speak for myself. But, sorry, I just kicked the table. I am no longer the needy fat girl. I mean, okay, besides the last few months that have been horrific, but there's a reason. It wasn't me. It was a reason, and that's something completely different. But I wasn't me the last few months. But this whole life as a size, what now, I think I'm 11 or something, it's really scary. But it's okay, because the friends I'm making in my life right now, they're not
going to tell you a story.
There's this old hen, big old hen in the forest, and she wants to make a pie, but she needs help. So she asks all her little friends, you know, forest friends, to go and gather things for her pie, like nuts and berries and all that stuff, so she can make the pie. So all of her friends are busy. All the little squirrels and all the little raccoons and little bunnies, they're all busy. They all say no. So she goes out and she gathers all her things that she needs for her pie herself. And she comes back and she asks her little friends to help her bake the pie. The bunnies and the raccoons and the squirrels, they're all too busy. Everybody's too busy. The deer, they're all busy. You get what I'm saying, right? So she bakes her own pie. And then when the pie is all done, it smells really good and it permeates all through the village. And all the animals are smelling it. And they all come running up to the windowsill of the big old hen's house. And she opens up her windows and she sets those pies on that windowsill. And she lets that smell permeate through the entire community of animals. And they all come up and they all want a piece of the pie. And the hen looks at the animals and she said, "Where were you when I were collecting my nuts? When I was collecting my nuts and my cherries and I needed your help, where were you then? This pie is mine." And so she ate the pie herself. Now, she probably needed a gastric bypass. But the whole story, the whole moral of that thing is I don't want to be that alone person anymore. So all the people that I have in my life now, all I have to do is ask for help and they're there. That's what I've created from gastric bypass. That's the kind of people that you're going to meet in the WLS community. Those kind of people that will go the extra mile if you ask for help. But you got to ask, because if you don't, we're not mind readers. And I've learned that as well. And I'm not a mind reader. And I've needed help the last couple months, and I haven't asked. Those that I did ask walked away because they didn't understand, which is okay. I didn't understand what was happening. I do now. And I'm not that fat girl that needs rescuing anymore. I'm not. I can stand on my own 2 feet, and that's what I'm doing. And I'll tell you, after the last couple of months going through that hell, it's really nice to be clear now. So I don't know if this has a purpose or not. I don't know. I don't really care. I just know if it can help and reach out to one person. Buy your papaya enzyme. Live your life like you want to live and you've always dreamed about living. Because I used to look at girls that were really thin and I used to say, "God, I wish I looked like that." Here's the news flash. Adieu.